Dear students, welcome to 15th session. In second module, so in this session we will discuss the introduction to the scientific management, a theory propounded by Frederick Winslow Taylor, popularly known as F.W. Taylor, and his associates. So in the last class, or in the last session, we discussed about the evolution of management thoughts from the period of ancient civilization, next in the period of Industrial Revolution, as well as the post-Industrial Revolution period, where we had the classical, neoclassical schools of management. So under the classical thought or classical approach, one of the very important management theories, scientific management theory. So we analyzed the different management thinkers as well as the different schools or approaches of management in the previous two sessions. So in this session, you will be able to understand the concept of scientific management, as well as you will be able to state the contributors of scientific management along with F.W. Taylor. Now, before we take scientific management theory, the prerequisites means what exactly demanded the scientific management theory. Due to certain loopholes in the factory system, so when the factories opened up because of the Industrial Revolution, andre naavu illi kaigarikiya athava audyomika kranti anta helteve 19th shatamanadalli ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಆಯಿತು. ಬೃಹತ್ ಪ್ರಮಾಣದ ಉತ್ಪಾದನೆ ಅಥವಾ ವಿಶ್ವವ್ಯಾಪಿ ಮಾರಾಟ ಅಥವಾ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿಕಲ್ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ಬೋದು. ಸೊ ಈ ಎಲ್ಲ ಚೇಂಜಸ್ ಆಗುವಾಗ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಮಾನವಾದ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಲ್ಸ್ ಇರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸಮ್ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವರ್ಕಿಂಗ್ ಎನ್ವೈರನ್ಮೆಂಟ್. There was no standard. There was a full of inefficient workers, and jobs were allocated to the people without matching the workers' skill or ability. And very important, there is no relationship between the workers with the management. Or maybe the management is not having faith on workers, or differences in identifying the talent or intelligence or motivating the workers. So observing all these loopholes, there was a strong demand for application of science in the management. So all these observation made by F.W. Taylor, practically when he was associated with the different companies, he observed the loopholes and he tried to improve the effectiveness or productivity of that factory by applying science in the management. So in this session, along with F.W. Taylor, we will discuss his associates and their contribution to the scientific management. So, a management approach formulated by F.W. Taylor in between 1890 to 1930, how scientific principles you can apply in management in all the areas. So what we observed in the prerequisite slide, so he is finding the solution for that, and because of the product is scientific management theory. So the main objective of scientific management theory, improving the economic efficiency of the factory, increasing the labor productivity, and building good relationship with the workers and management. So in the word of Taylor, he defined scientific management, knowing exactly what you want men to do and seeing that they do it in the best and cheapest way. So this definition is the gist of the scientific management. So in the coming session, we'll be discussing about the principles, elements of scientific management. So scientific management is ultimately knowing the best way of doing a particular job as well as in a cheapest way without any duplication or waste of resources. So earlier days, I think the trial and error method was in practice, or rule of thumb method was in practice. So when the changes are demanding in the market, in the technological era, or large scale companies, or severe competitions, so there was a need of a unified management concept, that is scientific management given by F.W. Taylor. Now we will discuss some information about F.W. Taylor's background, which are the positions he hold, as well as the contributions in terms of the books or in terms of the patent rights. So Taylor was born in German in 1856, and basically he was a mechanical engineering graduate from Steven Institute of Technology in 1883. Before that, he started as a laborer in a Midwell steel plant. Then he moved as a first line supervisor. And later, he observed numerous industrial practices that led him to his life's work. So started his career as an apprentice mechanist, then as an executive, he worked in Midwell Steel Factory as well as in Bethlehem Steel Company in 1898, and also he worked as a professor a Tuck School of Business, and later he became the president of the American Society of Mechanical Engineers in 1906, as well as he became consultant for various firms. So here the core ideas of scientific management based on his practical work experience. He published the first monographs, his piece rate system in 1895, shop management in 1903, as well as very popular book Principles of Scientific Management in 1911. So ultimately we can say that scientific management is the brainchild of F.W. Taylor, and therefore he was known as father of scientific management. He was known as father of scientific management. Because of his invention, he was the owner of 3 patent work: drawing of steam hammer, two-handed golf club, as well as the tennis racket with a curved handle. So he gave a different perspective to the management with the application of science. Due to his health issue, he died in 1915. Now, along with F.W. Taylor, there are many associates. They worked along with the scientific management movement. The first person is Carl George Langebarth. He developed a slide rule for every machine for the scientific measurements. Another personality is Henry L. Jant. So he was a very close associate with the Taylor. He was worked in 3 factories where F.W. Taylor also worked. So according to Gant, the worker selection incentives to the reward performance, as well as the mutuality of interest, will be the same thinking of F.W. Taylor. So very important contribution of Henry Gant is developing a charting system for the production scheduling known as Gantt chart. So Gantt chart alli prati kelasagarara kelasavannu avaru hege poornagolustare ಎಂಬುದನ್ನು ಒಂದು ಪ್ರತ್ಯೇಕ ಹಲಗೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬರೆದು ಪರಿಶೀಲಿಸಲಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ದಿ ಗ್ಯಾಂಟ್ ಚಾರ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿಂಗ್ ಎಸ್ ಎ ಬೇಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ 2 ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಆಪರೇಷನ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಸಿಪಿಎಂ, critical path method, as well as program evaluation and review technique known as PERT. So another very important contributors for scientific management movement is Frank and Lillian Gilbreth. So they are also worked along with the tailor. So they framed fatigue and motion studies in scientific management. Motion study andre naavu chalaneya samiksha anta helteve illi. With the minimum movement, we can reduce the time as well as we can finish the work. As well as fatigue study means giving some scope for interval. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ಕೆಲಸಗಾರರಿಗೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ರೀತಿಯ ಒಂದು ಬಿಡುವು ಕೊಡದೆ, ವಿರಾಮ ಕೊಡದೆ, ಸತತ ನೀವು 8 ಗಂಟೆ 10 ಗಂಟೆ ಕೆಲಸ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿಕೆ ಆಗುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ದೇ ನೀಡ್ ಸಮ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇಂಟರ್ವಲ್ ಬ್ರೇಕ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಔಟ್ಕಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಫಟೀಗ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಮೋಷನ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ದಟ್ ದೇ ಡೆವಲಪ್ಡ್ 17 ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಮೂವ್ಮೆಂಟ್ which is aiding the motion study, and each movement is called as turbulik. Alli turbulik anta bartade adu ee gill breath adara viruddha pada. So 17 movements they identified. It may be search or find or select or grasping, position, assembling, use. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ 17 ಚಲನೆಯನ್ನು ಅವರು ಕಂಡುಹಿಡಿದಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಟು ದ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ಅವರು ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥಾಪನೆಯ ಮನೋವಿಜ್ಞಾನ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಸೈಕಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಮ್ಯಾನೇಜ್ಮೆಂಟ್ book also written by these couples, Frank and Lillian Galbraith. Next, another personality in the scientific management is Harrington Emerson. He wrote 12 principles of efficiency. ಯಾವ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ದಕ್ಷತೆಯಿಂದ ಉತ್ಪಾದನೆಯನ್ನು ಹೆಚ್ಚಿಸಬಹುದು, ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ವೆಚ್ಚವನ್ನು ಇಳಿಸಬಹುದು. ಸೊ ಇವರು ಈ ದಕ್ಷತೆಯ ಬಗ್ಗೆ 12 ತತ್ವಗಳನ್ನು ಪ್ರತಿಪಾದಿಸುತ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಈ 12 ತತ್ವಗಳು ಶಿಸ್ತು ಅಥವಾ ಸರಿಯಾದ ದಾಖಲೆಗಳನ್ನು ಇಡುವಂಥದ್ದು, ಪ್ರಮಾಣಿತ ಸ್ಥಿತಿಗತಿಗಳು ಅಥವಾ ಪ್ರಮಾಣಿತ ಕಾರ್ಯನಿರ್ವಹಣೆ, ದಕ್ಷತೆಗಾಗಿ ಬಹುಮಾನವನ್ನು ಕೊಡುವಂಥದ್ದು, ಅಂಡ್ ಒನ್ ಮೋರ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾರಿಂಗ್ಟನ್ ಎಮರ್ಸನ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ಫಂಕ್ಷನಲ್ ಫೋರ್ಮ್ಯಾನ್ಶಿಪ್ ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಸೆಷನ್. ಅಂಡ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ Morris Cook. He suggested that management needed to tap the labor's brain. Means some kind of a freedom should be given to the workers also to get their viewpoints. So ultimately, when we think about scientific management theory, F.W. Taylor was a central figure in the development. But along with F.W. Taylor, there were many associates. They worked along with F.W. Taylor as well as they contributed to the development of scientific management theory. So kindly refer the following text as references for further information. Thank you.